Professor Tolkien, how did you come to write The Hobbit?
Well, I remember the beginning. I wrote it as a relief from examining a school certificate, as it was then called. One of the candidates had mercifully left one of the pages with no writing on it, which is the best thing that could possibly happen to an examiner. And I wrote on it, in a hole in the ground there lived a hobbit. The names always generate a story in my mind. Eventually I thought I'd better find out what hobbits were like. But that's only the beginning. I just spun a yarn out of any elements in my head. I don't remember organising things at all.
Did your children take any part in your telling the story?
Well, they were so used to me scribbling and writing on that kind of thing that until I got something more worthwhile to read them, they didn't take much interest. But I think they did, on the whole, like the Hobbit story. It was sufficient interest for me to go on and finish it. I stuck several times.
Would you call The Hobbit a fairy story?
Well, I think, in a sense, anything's a fairy story that contains either creatures that are called fairies or elves, or any of the kind of ingredients of the ordinary fairy stories of our northern world. So it is a fairy story in that sense. That is, it's about times or places where you might meet things like fairies. But that is not the whole story, of course. Perhaps the most important is the lecture which I gave at the British Academy, which was entitled Beowulf, the Monsters. I also once gave a paper to the Philological Society on which was entitled Chaucer as a Philologist. And last of all, the most recent, I suppose, was my Andrew Land lecture as an essay on fairy stories. Those are the three, I think, perhaps the most things in which I've been perhaps most effective, any, on the subject which I profess. No, I don't know what I can. No, we know nothing about them, hardly. Whose work had led to the downfall of Sora. Also, she passed the great temptation. The ring was actually offered to her by employed to etymologies, and I ran into quite a lot of them.
What would you have done if you had been a little boy and a wizard had come and asked you to go to the Misty Mountains and help kill a dragon?
I've been very well brought up to avoid conversations with dubious old gentlemen. I should have retired into the house and asked my mother. I was swept away, partly by an inner weakness that says yes, but mostly with a feeling of no, into becoming a party of people who are going on expedition, exploring expedition.
About ancient Swedish history. It's really rather a document of Swedish history in England. But it happens to be entirely English in its literary and
science.
It's hideous, though. It was meant to be hideous. Do you want that as a contract? Motion thing, Kiryanna, to a ship, Kiryasi, in, by, or on a ship, Kiryallo, from a ship. The plural is Kirya, Kiryarion, the genitive. Kiryas, Kiryasin, Kiryannar, Kiryallor. Instrumental is Kiryanen in the singular and Kiryainen in the plural. That's enough to go on as well.
10, take one.
Professor, it has been said that there's no religion in your books, there's no God.
Place, or by implication, as in the conversation about between Gandalf and Frodo, what it was of directing the finding of the ring. You must have, I think, in this kind of narrative, something that has the same emotive and situation as the god, as the gods, Olympic gods, and other gods in which he's had the existence of our first created minds and spirits, the demiurgic angelic spirits, where they appear as the valour or powers. They're not gods. But if you want a brief notion of the mythological world, it consists of the...
We do want to catch this, so we better wait till they reload.
Oh, good.
8, take 1.
It depends on what you mean by factory. I mean, a factory may be a very big or a very large, a very small thing. Love them, love writing them, like driving them. It's too many of them, yes, quite, but the evil of all things it must be judged apart from the multiplication table, because the multiplication table makes evil out of practically everything. I think the most tragic point in the whole story is how good, the terrible irony that good often does evil. The most tragic moment is when Sam in his protectiveness just take your hands off and therefore defeats Gollum's repentance. Because that seems to be very true to life. The last part of my work was actually done, as I now discover, to my great pleasure, because I was always a diffident lecture. I had never any idea whether I was having any effect or not. And it's pleasant in later years to discover that I must have had quite a considerable effect through the form of lectures. I was an assiduous lecturer, which is partly why I was not an assiduous writer. I took a great deal of trouble over lectures, lectured a great deal more than my statutes demanded on lots of different subjects. Before I actually got an actual job in any university, I was, owing to the kindness of people who found an unfortunate war-returned officer with nothing much to do, I was working as Professor Bradley's assistant on the Oxford Dictionary. I was invalided at that part of my time in the war. I think the last things I can remember about was being up in Blackpool, in a hospital which once been the Hydro. Anyway, I eventually went for a board. I remember, I think it was just after Bulgaria collapsed out of the war and everybody thought things end was coming, and I went before a very good medical, charming medical board who said, I think you'd better go back to Oxford and finish your education. Which, of course, as a proud young man who'd already taken his degree, I felt rather offensive, but I didn't realise my luck. I came back to Oxford with wife and child, and we lived in lodgings in St. John Street, and I still went about in uniform, receiving a pension. But eventually that dried up, and I made my living out of taking freelance pupils. To mine, I think nearly everybody else is surprised. I was a young man, I suppose. I actually became elected to professorship at Oxford at the age of 33, which was more more provided by luck than merit. But at the same time, one has to, I suppose, to look back at oneself and wonder what has billed one for this kind of thing. I think a good education, particularly the enormous fortune of being born of parents of a certain kind, particularly having an extremely attractive, beautiful, and extremely able mother. So that many of the clashes, quarrels, and it have never affected me. It never occurred to me to think that shouldn't be interested in languages and poetry and so on. And one of the things that most interfered with my getting a good classical degree in Oxford, I did well enough, I ought to have done better, what's coming across Finnish language. Well, now, that's, again, another entirely different sensation. I've never been very good at Finnish, but its formation, its sound texture is very remarkable. It actually makes me quite intoxicated. I just went away and learnt this when I would have been doing other things, and people could make out why my essays on the Greek drama were getting worse and worse. For my present knowledge of history and of that part of the world, it must be pretty clear I must have had a great deal of, I'm not talking general British blood, but actually Welsh-speaking blood not far back in my ancestry. I've always been fascinated by my Welsh, which seems a language whose word structure and so on gives me extreme pleasure. My mother was obviously had philological talents which had not been developed by education, and she awoke them to me by pointing out the similarity and also the very systematic similarity between German and English words. But I think I inherited this quite apart from comparative philology, because I was always puzzled if anything was taught me about how you ought to write and how you should do this and how you should do that. The best, one of the best forms for a long narrative is the, as was found in The Hobbit, though this is a much more elaborate form, of the pilgrimage on journey with an object. So that was inevitably the form I adopted.